Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Simone Short.
Welcome to this week's show, where we'll be talking about a new whale trail happening in Bass Coast, erosion at the Inverloch Surf Beach, but first up, a bit of info about the new community grants for Phillip Island community groups and organisations.
That's right, Lauren. Following a decision at the May ordinary meeting, Council is managing the Phillip Island Community Benefit Fund for the Phillip Island community. There's over $140,000 worth of grants available, with these funds coming from electronic gaming machine losses from the Continental Hotel in Cowes. Grants will be available in amounts ranging from $5,000 to $25,000, so this is a great opportunity for Phillip Island groups and organisations seeking funding for any exciting new projects they may have in the pipeline.
Grant applications will be open from Monday the 5th of September this year until Wednesday the 1st of March 2017, and all not-for-profit groups based on the island are encouraged to apply. The guidelines for the grants are available on Council's website at basscoast.vic.gov.au/grants.
Now, we know that applying for grants can be a little confusing or time consuming, so we're also running two information sessions so that you can come along and ask any questions and also get a bit of a hand navigating the online form. Session one will be held on Tuesday the 23rd of August from 5:30 p.m. until 6:30 p.m. at Meeting Room 1 of the Cowes Cultural Centre. Session two will be held on Tuesday the 6th of September from 5 p.m. until 6 p.m. at the Phillip Island Visitor Information Centre in New Haven.
To register to attend or for more information, please contact Council's Grants Officer on Grant Inquiry at basscoast.vic.gov.au or call the numbers at the end of the show.
Thanks, Lauren. Now, it's safe to say we've had some wild weather this winter, and the combination of large tides and swells, including a couple of king tides, have caused significant erosion to the Inverloch Surf Beach, including the Surf Life Saving Tower and the beach access track. Council's Municipal Building Surveyor and a structural engineer have assessed the tower and surrounds. And while it isn't currently a risk to the public, that section of the beach has been closed due to the unstable sand cliffs. Council's also in talks with the Department of Environment, Water, Land and Planning, as well as the Inverloch Surf Life Saving Club, to determine the future of the observation tower.
Many of us live in Bass Coast because we love the environment, but that also means Mother Nature challenges us with a dynamic coastline that is always changing, and unfortunately we can't hold back the tide. So please be patient, and I know we're all a little curious to see the changing beach, but please avoid the area until it can be made safe again.
I don't know about you, Lauren, but I think spotting a pod of whales from the shores of Bass Coast is a pretty exciting thing, and this is why Council is creating the Bass Coast Whale Trail between Phillip Island and Inverloch, thanks to $25,000 in funding from the federal government's National Landcare Program.
The trail will include educational and interpretive signs at several well-known whale watching locations along our coastline, which will give both locals and visitors the chance to watch out for majestic whales during their annual migration at the best viewing locations around.
The project has involved a number of discussions so that the finished product will reflect what our community would like to see, with a lot of involvement from Watershed Victoria in particular. Council is already working on the planning with land managers and stakeholders, including Watershed Victoria and Whale Watch Gippsland. This project has been a long time coming, so we'd like to thank the local groups involved for their passion and persistence in advocating so that it could become a reality. And we'll keep you all updated on the trail's progress.
I've never actually seen a whale before, Simone, so I'm super excited to know exactly where to keep an eye out for one. Now, just a couple of reminders before we go. Council's monthly ordinary meeting is coming up next week on Wednesday the 18th of August, kicking off from 5 p.m. at the Council Chamber in the Civic Centre in Wonthaggi. Community members are always welcome to come along, and there are plenty of topics on the agenda for Council to discuss on the night.
And the Stand for Council information sessions are fast approaching, so if you're thinking of stepping up to represent your community, you really should get along to one of them to find out more. Head to the official website, standforcouncil.com.au, and click the yellow box on the right titled Briefing Sessions, and you'll see the details for the Bass Coast sessions on the 22nd, 23rd and 25th of August.
Thanks, Simone. That's all we've got time for this week. If you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 B-Coast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. And don't forget to follow us on social media on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Be sure to tune in next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.